The curious case of the exploding AWS bill. A software engineer's comedy of errors. Our protagonist, Massey Edge, a seasoned software engineer, embarked on a seemingly innocent journey, building a document indexing system. He created a humble S3 bucket in the EU West 1 region, the digital equivalent of renting a small storage unit in Ireland. He uploaded some files for testing, feeling confident he was well within the free tier limits, like a shopper carefully calculating the cost of groceries to avoid exceeding their budget. 2 days later, the AWS billing page delivered a punchline worthy of a dark comedy. Massey Edge's bill was a staggering $1,300, with the culprit being nearly 100 million S3 put requests within a single day. It was like returning to your storage unit to find it filled with 100 million bricks, each with a hefty invoice attached. Where did all these requests come from? Massey Edge wondered, bewildered. AWS, by default, doesn't log requests made to S3 buckets, keeping its secrets like a tight-lipped librarian. But fear not, for CloudTrail and S3 server access logging exist, like trusty detectives ready to crack the case. Enabling CloudTrail logs, Massey Edge discovered a horde of write requests from various accounts, some even from outside AWS. It was like finding footprints of not just one, but a whole troop of mysterious intruders in his storage unit. Was this some DDoS attack? He pondered, imagining digital villains bombarding his bucket with malicious intent. However, the truth was far more bizarre. An open-source tool, whose name remains a secret to protect the innocent and the data, had a default configuration, setting its backup location to, you guessed it, Massey Edge's S3 bucket. Every deployment of this tool was like a well-meaning but clueless delivery person, mistakenly dropping off packages at his doorstep. But why should I pay for their mistake? Massey Edge rightfully questioned. As it turns out, S3 charges for unauthorized requests too. It's like getting a bill for all the misdelivered packages, even though you never ordered them. Even a simple command like /aws/s3cp file. txt s3 skeptical smiley face your bucket name random_key would result in an access denied error for the sender, but a charge for our unfortunate protagonist. The plot thickened when over half the bill came from the East 1 region, where Massey Edge had no bucket. The answer: S3 requests without a specified region default to US East 1 and are then redirected. It's like the delivery person going to the wrong address, realizing their mistake, and then charging you extra for the detour. Now, here's where the story takes a hilarious turn. Massey Edge thought, if all these systems are trying to back up their data here, why not let them? He opened his bucket for public writes and within 30 seconds, collected over 10 gigabytes of data. It was like opening his door to find a mountain of misdelivered packages, each containing a piece of someone else's life. Of course, he couldn't disclose the contents, but it highlighted the potential for a data leak of epic proportions. From this comedic tragedy, Massey Edge learned valuable lessons. Lesson 1. Anyone who knows your S3 bucket name can inflate your AWS bill. It's like giving someone the keys to your storage unit and letting them fill it with whatever they want while you foot the bill. Lesson 2. Use random suffixes for your bucket names. It's like adding a secret code to your storage unit to keep out unwanted guests. Lesson 3. Specify the AWS region when making S3 requests. It's like giving the delivery person the correct address to avoid unnecessary detours and charges. In the aftermath, Massey Edge reported his findings to the open source tool maintainers, who promptly fixed the default configuration. He also notified the AWS security team, suggesting they restrict the problematic bucket name to protect customers and data. However, AWS, like a strict landlord, wasn't willing to intervene in the affairs of its tenants. Massey Edge even contacted two companies whose data he found. But alas, his emails were likely lost in the spam folder, like messages in a bottle cast into the digital sea. Finally, AWS, in a rare act of benevolence, canceled his S3 bill. But they emphasized this was an exception, not the rule. So, dear reader, let this be a cautionary tale. Guard your S3 bucket names like precious treasures, and remember, even an empty bucket can lead to a comedically disastrous AWS bill.
Once a coder with the task at hand, in the cloud his project planned. A bucket created files to test, but next day's bill left him distressed. Empty bucket, empty wallet, AWS bill made him holler. Another